Technical difficulties. I didn't even know that was possible in a YouTube video. Hello, everyone, and welcome back to the walkthrough. Let's start 5-1, and what is this? Certainly looks like some sort of tournament, doesn't it? Indeed it does, and we're both invincible right at the start, as you can tell there. This will either go really quickly, or it'll take me a while. This is... Right now, it's actually at 5-2, believe it or not. They don't number these for whatever reason. They're all, like, in a row. And it goes all the way up to the boss, and somehow I managed to kill it. I am surprised. So this could either be a really quick or a really long episode, because the AI gets a lot more tricky as you go along the way, and I am going to... Hello! Wait, actually, that's pretty much useless here. And your firepower is pathetic. See, now, as you can see, the AI is getting a whole lot better. And also, may I add, notice that... Oh, jeez! Oh, God! No! No! Oh, poopers. That skull right there is a... It makes you go super fast and makes you drop bombs like crazy. And, yeah, I'll just take advantage of that there. Let me... Thank you. That skull is a bad power-up, needless to say. It has various different kinds of things, and it will likely kill you in some occasions, like you've seen right there. So do not get the skull and blow it up when you see it. That is a common item in multiplayer, though, and it is a contagious power-up, meaning if you touch somebody, you will transfer that quote-unquote power over to them. That could be used to your advantage, but also could be to your disadvantage. Like, you seen that one over there, it was me going super fast and dropping bombs like crazy. And I couldn't stop myself from dropping bombs. That's just simply how the power works. Do not let that get the kick. Ever! That would be very helpful for the enemy, and I can't have that. Wait, how did that... Oh, the bomb blast must have went over the Bomberman, yeah. That works for me, I guess. Oh no, why did you grab that? Don't touch me! Oh, it's auto-dropping bombs. And man, the firepower of these guys are really, really small. I thought it was a whole lot bigger, unless I'm thinking of the boss. Because I know for sure the boss is overpowered like heck. As you'll see shortly, I'm quite worried about how long this part is going to be. I mean, I'm already near the boss. Dang it! No, you got the fire power up, and I just... Oh, and it also... the time ran out, I died, and this one apparently takes more than one hit. Whoa, maximum firepower! I'll take that! this is a lot like the multiplayer battle mode, actually, which I'll be showing you a little bit later. I'll be doing it in my normal one-player version, of course, as usual. Namely, because the computer AI is ridiculous in the battle mode, no matter which level you try it on. But anyway, if this ends up being a shorter than usual part, I'll just splice in the sixth level, and actually the sixth and final level, actually, and make this like an... a little bit longer part than usual. No, 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 you are not going to get... You got it. Curses! Yeah, I see that there's a little flare-out that the... If my bomb explodes after the enemy's bomb, I should say the other Bomberman's bomb, what'll happen is that it'll get pushed through their explosion. So now I see how it works. I didn't really notice that before when I used to play that long ago, but I sort of picked up on it now. And dang it, just die already! It shouldn't be that hard. Maybe I should be trying to do something like this. Like, then kick it over. And that was terrible timing on my part. I was gonna kick it over and stop it. Oh, no, 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 no. Oh, God, no! And it's the same one again. This is suicide. Ah! That is ridiculous. Especially when you have that many bombs and the explosion radius is that high, they just keep chaining on you. Alright, get rid of those dang skull power-up. They're not really a power-up, they're some sort of thing. I believe they're called poison, actually. I'm not positive of that, but I just call them skulls because, well, there's a skull on them. It's kind of obvious in that way. And by the way, the enemy, if you don't notice it, the enemy knows your bomb blast radius. So they will dodge your explosions based on their... Oh, I want that, I want that, I want that more than anything. They will dodge your explosions based on their placement. Like, I mean, they're by their distance. I want to cheat this a little bit. I forgot that they blast in the order that you press... I mean, that you drop them in. That's my bad there. Alright, must strategically place... Yeah! There we go! That makes things a whole lot easier. that's gonna blast mine, isn't it? Yeah. I could use this, though. I can safely go across here and... Oh, dang it! I put them in the wrong order of trickery. Alright, now if I were to do this... It's not far enough, apparently. Oh, there we go. It doesn't really matter, I guess. Alright. Oh, dear. Whoa, what happened to the audience? What's going on? Help! I want my mommy. Oh, dear. Oh, my. Who is the new top hat guy? And who is this bomber? He looks pretty nasty. Let's take him on. He starts out invincible. This is not going to go well for me, especially with the timer. Just look at that. And yeah, this is the boss. Got a lot of firepower here. Gotta look out. And I'm gonna lose anyway. By the way, if you use the boxing glove and hit a bomb over to the other side, what'll happen is that it'll jump across, I should say, it'll break the fourth wall and go across the screen. Wait, can I just, like, cheese this a little bit? If he's gonna give me that power, I'm gonna take advantage of it, dang it. Give me extra time, even though I beat the level. Yeah, this is going to be a shorter than usual part, so what I'm gonna be doing here is just continuing on with the level, I should say continuing on with World 6. And I'm gonna save right here, and hold on a sec, please. Alright, here we are. We are in a new place. What is this place? I'm leaving it up to your imagination at the moment. And it starts out with really, really basic enemies for whatever reason, but the music, very sinister, but very cool at the same time. I don't really get what the heck these boxes are. As you can see, they are moving, like the edges of them are moving ever so slightly. I should not have put a bomb there. Because, yeah, it's gonna respawn that guy, but I just didn't know it was there at the moment, but whatever, it's not really that big of a deal. It's just there. These are all really, really easy enemies, as I said. Come on, go somewhere, like, now he's gonna be unpredictable, isn't it? Yeah, you're just gonna be a troublemaker, aren't you? I don't want to blast certain boxes, as you can tell, at certain times, because otherwise they will... Oh, that was pretty lucky. Because otherwise what'll happen is that, you know, I'll release more possibilities for them to move, and then it'll sometimes make it harder to kill them. And I should not put a bomb between those two. That would be tragic. Because I'll hit the exit, and whoa, I just a little spazzed out there on the controller. That could have been bad. one more box. Hello! Wall walk power up, and that's all. I should mention, because I keep forgetting to mention this, these stages right here, they're actually randomized to a point. Like, the placement of the boxes are pretty much the same. I mean, the placement of the boxes and enemies are different, but the enemies and the power-ups that appear in each of these levels are pretty much the same. In fact, I think they are all the same, if I'm not mistaken. So, that's why I'm able to make this... You just dodged my bomb blast! How dare you! I forgot about that with those little turtle guys, is that they have the power to dodge your blast and then appear at a different random area. Those square guys, still pretty sucky. I mean, they try, I guess. You gotta give them points for that. So, anyway, as I said with this game, it's about more strategy than anything. That's why I'm able to make this walkthrough on it, despite it being a pretty randomized game. And this is going to take care of him. And I might as well finish off the rest of these boxes. There we go. And I just noticed that my bomb blast almost hit over to the goal there. Because it was going to do one of those things that I told you about in the battle arena part. And now we've got these I don't know, Christmas tree-like enemy things. They're really weird. They do home in on you, and they're very good at dodging your bomb blasts, so be very cautious as to which blocks you destroy before you make yourself too vulnerable to them. But I have the wall walk here, so I'm pretty good. I'm just sort of taking advantage of this as much as I possibly can, just because, you know, I have a wall walk. I mean, why not? But these tree guys, they are some of the worst enemies in the game. I mean, they take so many hits, and they're good at dodging your stuff. Yeah. And you gotta use the little bomb guard thing that I taught you at times to help help prevent yourself from dying. And should I have gotten that boxing glove? I am unsure at this moment. But I guess we will never know if I'll need that. Wait, actually, can I? No, I don't have the boxing glove. I forgot that I lost it in the timeouts that I kept getting in that battle arena tournament type place. Hello! I'm happy I stayed. You know, to check the rest of the boxes. Woo! Next stage! Now it looks like we're... Oh my. Who are these night guys? I don't know. But they are pretty troublesome in that if they see you, they'll charge at you. They're like the bull. And as you'll notice, that they have a shield, which prevents them from getting hit. That's a pretty bad trait they have there. Come on, go over here. And they also aim for you if they see you, as you see that there. Come on, gotta hit them like from the side or the back. And, you know, they can't see your bombs either, otherwise they'll just guard them. So that works for me. The remote control power-up is extremely handy versus these things. They are probably the most threatening enemy in the entire game. They take a lot of hits, in case you can't tell. And that's pretty much all there is to these guys. Come on, this way, please. Well, actually, that works. That works for me, I suppose. Let's move that there. Yeah, finally. I wasn't really counting how many. Oh no! Why did I do that? And I wasn't even paying attention to where I was blasting. Ah! I have to deal with them all over again. How could I be so foolish? Oh, and he guarded it. Curse you! Sneaky snakes all over the place. And we'll off to the side. When he turns around, gonna do that. Yeah, I just get 2 hits per round. Takes care of that one. Extra life. That's pretty nice. Oh, don't do that. You can tell they definitely go for you by the way that they move. Like, they twitch off to the side and stuff like that. And time it. Yahoo! And that's the end of the stage. I almost ran out of time there. That would have been pretty tragic. 6-5! Let's start. And I... You know what? Why don't I just wall walk through a lot of these things? I mean, oh, jeez, that's gonna get in my way, because it's right in the center. Takes care of them. Ah, those dang Christmas tree critters. Why must you be there? You cause so much ire to me. Come on down. See, they're deliberately not turning down that route, because there was no... I mean, because there was a bomb down that route. They are very smart enemies, and you gotta trick them. Either by letting them go down a route, then drop a bomb so that they run into it. But even so, they can still double back and, you know... Oh, look at that! Oh, no, wait, he's trapped by the blue guy, and I just made a mistake with my bombs. Poopers, I'm not paying attention. 2-for-1 deal right there. I'm gonna grab extra time, because I don't want to lose more lives. I'm hoping to play this game without getting a game over. That would be pretty interesting, actually. Because I don't think I've ever done that, even as a kid, when I used to play this game like crazy. Hey, you! This way. Yes, you. Thank you. Come on. Nibble, nibble. Too bad for you. That just doesn't work. The power of the remote control bombs just destroys those guys. But otherwise, you'd have to time it by waiting about 5 squares. I mean, by placing a bomb and letting them walk into it 5 squares away. And 6-6. Let's go. Ah! Evil Breathmints return! Well, at least they only take 1 hit. They're not nearly as bad as the Christmas tree guys. And I'm definitely taking advantage of my invincibility time there, just because I can, but I'm not cheesing it by using the infinite bomb blasts radius thing. Oh, I got another one, but that doesn't help me in the least, so I don't know why I'm excited. It's just nice to see them every once in a while. Oh, Christmas trees. Such an issue. Ah! He almost turned and dodged it. And the helicopter guys, 5 hits. Way too many. And I believe the timer at the top there drops a lot faster depending on the level. Like the further you get into the game, the faster the time drops. Oh, there we go. There it is. That's what I was looking for, of course. But what's in the other ones? Absolutely nothing. So we're just going to move on. 6-7, the last one before the final boss. Hello. Good thing I got the extra life there. That makes me happy. I have a feeling that the final boss is going to give me some trouble because I don't remember it very much. I'll probably recognize it when I see it. Dang you, Christmas trees. Turn around this way, please. Thank you. And they just keep walking even though you hit them. There's no stun time or anything like that. They're just such a problem. That takes care of that. Where is the exit? I do not know. Does it matter? Not really. I mean, I'm fully powered up to pretty much anything that I would need. So, I can't believe I just did that. Of all the things, I mean, it was right after I said, whatever. I might as well beat the final boss with legitness. I need the boxing glove for the final boss, too. I remember that. And the final boss has 2 phases, I remember that too, but I don't remember how to defeat it. Alright, here we go! Oh dear. Oh my. Oh, I remember, you have to hit its thing when it's open, that red thing on its front. Whatever the heck you can call that thing, and it walks all around the field, it drops powerful bombs. Yeah, like that. You gotta try to wait for it to... Yeah, wait for it to open up and shoot its bomb so that you can hit it like that. This would be child's play if it was, you know, if I still had my remote control there. But otherwise, this may cause me a tad of problems. Oh my. Oh dear. Oh dear. I didn't predict properly which order the bombs were going to explode, and that was my downfall there. Maybe I should have taken advantage of the invincibility time there, I don't know. I really hope he goes back to the top of the screen. This is so hard to hit him when he's down there. Thank you! Wait, don't shoot any at the top. Okay, that's good. I'm just gonna fetal position up here, if you don't mind. Don't! Stop moving down! I know you're kind of random, but still, you gotta work with me here a little bit. Come on. Come on, man! And you'll notice that he protects himself from his own bombs by closing his hatch like that. That's why he does that. I'm not going to be able to... Yeah. I don't think he actually drops any bombs down that one square lane in the front there like that. Man, he's loud. I'm just going to... Yeah, I don't think he plops any down where I am here. So I guess this is sort of safe in a way. Yeah. I'm just going to do that. That makes me quite happy. Okay, so I can take advantage of his placement over here. Okay, now he's gonna open up. Gotta wait for him to stop and then plop a bomb. Good. I have a rhythm. Yeah. Drop one here. Dodge it. Let it explode before the rest of them. But those other bombs are so freaking random. Random is sometimes dangerous. Well, there we go. Something looked a little weird there. And now I need to wait for a boxing glove. One will eventually appear around here. But in the meantime, I just gotta wait. They will plop those things out, the skull poison power-up things, if you want to even call them a power-up. And your best bet to prevent yourself from running into them is just to keep blasting them along the way. Oh, I just got a health power-up. Now, if I were to ever take a hit, what'll happen is that... I don't think I got a heart in this entire walkthrough. What'll happen is that I won't die instantly. I'll actually be able to continue on, which is pretty nice. Man, my firepower is pretty massive. Where is the punch power-up? unless I am not capable of doing anything because I don't have it. I don't remember in the slightest. I forgot about that. If they run over your bomb blast, what'll happen is that if they roll over your bomb, it'll explode it instantly. Yeah, you can't hit them when they're in the air like that. But I could have swore that... Oops. I could have swore that boxing gloves did appear... Or at least they did eventually. Because I don't think the game would make you get it from an earlier stage, would they? That just seems unreasonable. Oh, see, it does drop random power-ups along the area, so I do just have to wait for one of the boxing gloves to appear, eventually. I'd hate the game over for the sake of, you know, bad luck. If there's one thing that I hate is losing by luck. I mean, because it's not like that I lose because, you know, I was outwitted or something like that. It's simply because I'm not getting what I should be getting. And that sort of thing in any kind of game infuriates me. There we go. Now just punch bombs into it like that. And that's how you hit them. Otherwise, I gotta be extra careful now. Because I'm at my last life. Oh, shoot. And if he runs over a bomb as I punch it at him, I am doomed. Maybe I should be hitting it like, something like that. Like, as he's coming off the side. Crap! No! I just slowed down to the slowest time. And, well, actually, this sort of works for me because it does show what I was wondering earlier, wherever you get your password from. And sure enough, you get it from the game over screen here. So I'm going to continue and then resume my recording once I beat this stage again. See, if you ever game over, what'll happen is that you go back to the last stage you played. So I have to replay this one. You know what? I'm just gonna cheat this. So I'll see you back on the final boss. Alright, took care of phase one, let's start phase two, and just for the fun of it, I'm starting it right at the very beginning because I want to see how long it takes for a boxing glove to appear again. As you see, I've lost all the powers that I've had, but at the same time, it seems like this would be more useful than not, because the super large bomb blasts that I had were the things that were sort of killing me. I mean... Because, you know, when they would walk across, I mean, when he would fly across my bombs and then, you know, it would explode in my face, no matter how far away I was, because I had maximum fire. And yeah, so I think that's actually going to work for me. But dang it, I really wish I could have done this, you know, without getting a game over or something like that. I mean, that is just a shame. Ah, my record still stands that I have never gotten a game... I have always gotten a game over, and I just couldn't break that, alas. This game is a fairly hard game, actually. I'm just a pretty decent Bomberman player. But as I said before, when I die via luck, it's not something that I really approve of. In turn, I don't really play luck-based games as a result, because it's like, okay... So I lost, and I lost beyond my power. It's not like I could have prevented it via skill. And if I win by luck, it's like, well, so what? I won by luck. It doesn't really matter. It's not like that I, you know, achieve something by winning by luck. That's how I feel about luck-based games, basically. So I avoid them at all costs. Well, okay, maybe not at all costs, but you get the idea. All right, I'm hoping that I'm not gonna die... Because it took me quite a while to get that boxing glove again. I ran over it, and I should not open my mouth. Opening my mouth today is just terrible. Oh, there it is again. PkGam can use this. Don't touch me. Don't touch me. Thank you. I do not like physical contact. Oh, come on. That was totally a hit. And that was a hit? That grazed the side. Whatever. I shouldn't question... Oh, there we go. I shouldn't question the logic of how they die. Woo! Alright! Now for the storyline. As I said, I was going to tell you along the way. Why didn't I tell you this earlier? Well, I wanted to do something different. I've said before that engaging gameplay doesn't need a story, and I was hoping to show that in this walkthrough. Also, lately on DeviantArt, I've had a lot of fun looking at art in general, especially the ones that the artist doesn't describe, as silly as that sounds, because it allows me and others to paint their own picture and thoughts about what the artist had in mind and just have fun with them in general, you know, just really try and pick them apart, so to speak, and, you know, well, I guess you don't know unless you're looking at art and stuff like that, but anyway, so by leaving you to figure out the story, you would be doing the same, essentially. Well, aside from, you know, me telling you the story right now, unless you don't want to hear me explain the story to you, then just leave the video right now. But basically, I did that sort of thing as a kid, and I enjoyed it quite a bit, so I was hoping to share that kind of experience about the story. Anyway, now for the story. I wrote this all down, so this part is sort of scripted. this first part is actually from the instruction booklets that I reworded my way. North of Bomberman's hometown, Peacetown, there's a place called Diamond City. Carrot Diamond, the guy with the top hat, and Dr. Mook, the short mohawk guy in the lab coat, is holding a robot tournament. Well, us Bombermen, I should say, are, of course, invited. But the purpose of this tournament was actually to steal Bomberman's advanced capabilities. I don't know how they were going to do that, but that was the purpose of the tournament. Diamond made a fake Bomberman to go to Peacetown to kidnap the real Bomberman, but Black Bomberman was savvy to the plan and wanted to stop it. So he confronted the fake one alone, and failed. And his castle was taken as a result. Somehow he escapes and goes to regroup with White Bomberman and tell him of their plan. Very quickly, many enemy robots appear and advance towards their town to take it over. So they then take them on, one stage at a time, location to location. Let's see here. I'm just looking at what else I wrote here. Can I actually click to go to the title screen, or am I stuck here? I am not sure. Well, I guess I can tell you about the levels now. Level 1 is, of course, Peacetown. The first levels take place on the streets, the next are at the eastern side of the village, and the last few take place in Black Bomberman's castle. I pointed out that the stage locations were changing, or I should say I was hinting that the locations were changing from time to time, but never said why until now. See, this game actually takes you on a journey from location to location, even within each of the individual levels. Anyway, level 2 is, as you probably guessed, the robot amusement park. It starts out at a place called Playland, it's not really a good name if you ask me, and ends inside the mystery circus where you fight that... Ugh, clown! Ugh! never mind. Level 3 is at Mook's Robot Remodeling Factory, starting outside in the garden and working your way in, basically. I assume the happy jumping Bomberman Bombermen you see after beating Mook were going to be remodeled, but you ended up saving them by defeating them. I assume that they were going to get, like, remodeled into the evil Bombermen you see in level 5, you know, the tournament. Anyway, level 4 is, it takes place in the Robot Qualifier Dome. Yeah, that was how it ended with the karate robot boss thing on that electric arena place thingy. So that explains that as well, you know, because he looked like some sort of, well, he was definitely a robot, but I mean that, you know, he looked to be quite the fighter. Level 5 is at the Robot Tournament Grounds, obviously, where the competition takes place. Needless to say, at the epic battle with the Yellow Bomberman thing with superpower is how it ended. Though, I still wonder what the heck happened to those audience members. I mean, they flashed in and out, and I don't know, maybe they just weren't there to begin with, and they were just like a red herring or something, I don't know. level 6 is at Diamond Tower itself. You defeat the main baddies and save the day. Pretty simple. You just work your way in through the tower, floor to floor. And that's pretty much it. This part's gone on long enough. So I think I'm going to end it off here. I hope you enjoyed. And I will see you in the next part when I start doing some battle mode stuff. Oh, and there's also some cheats and secrets in the game I'll cover later. But as for now, I'm done.